So today is the day that the E36 is finally going to get wider, just on the front. So I didn't record the installation of the plastic fenders, white fenders, because I was doing it for the first time and wasn't sure what is the best possible way to do it right. But I'm going to walk you through what I have done to install them. It's not so hard. As you can see, guys, right now it looks really ugly because the tire is not so wide, but we're going to fix that later in the video. So about the installation, this is the edge that I was using for the front, and this is the edge that I was using for the backside to this line. And I cut it my original fenders. This is how much I cut it. This is from the both fenders. This is probably from the right, and this is from the left fender. This is how much I cut it. It's not so much, but it's enough to not hitting the tire. And for installation, I just used rivets. How much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's around 9 or 10 rivets for every side. Not sure did I made it here good, but I just cut a little bit to be able to put this plastic cover here. But the wheel arch of the fender is not looking very good. I'm going to show you. Like you can see, it's not on the center, but doesn't matter. This will be something like missile car, so this doesn't matter. I'm going to leave it like that. And pretty much this is how. I just used paper tape to hold the plastic fender and started to drill holes for the rivets itself. Pretty straightforward, nothing so hard. I'm still not sure, am I going to install it on the rear side, because not sure, probably I'm going to get too much grip when I install it on the back. For now I'm going to just leave it on the front side. And now, let's see what mods we're going to install today. So this is the plan for today. We have 2 spacers for the front, 10 new tires, new nuts, camber and caster plates for the shocks on the front. So I'm going to undone the studs on the spacers and going to apply on them thread locking compound. This is the most harder one. When you try to undone them, you're going to need to heat them up pretty good to be able to undone them. So that's why I'm going to use it, so the threads not come loose. And this is the plan for today. So the thickness of the spacers is 30 millimeters. I'm going to show you. 30 millimeters of thickness on every spacer. Okay, the installing on the spacers is pretty straightforward job. The most important thing is this surface of the disc should be very clean and even. So I'm going to try to clean it very good, and after that I'm going to install the spacer. This is how the surface should look before installing the spacer, and now I'm going to use aluminium paste anti-seize to prevent the spacer to stuck on the hub when you decide to remove it. So before installing the spacer, I'm going to remove the tooth. So you can clearly see to where the stud was tightened. So I'm going to apply thread locker to this point and I'm going to tie them up to the spacer when I install it on the disc itself. Because if I install it before that, the stud can look like that and can push the spacer a little bit. So I'm going to use the original bolt for the wheel and I'm going to put it like that and going to install them. Okay, I'm going to tighten the bolts to 140 Nm in crisp patterns way. So I'm going to apply a thread locking compound on the stud. And I'm going to use my finger to put it even on all the threads. So I already done two studs, this is the third one that I'm doing. And I'm going to use these two to tighten a little bit harder. Nothing too excessive. And I'm going to repeat this process on the other two studs and on the other side. All the studs are installed with the thread locker. Now, the most blink time, the nuts. Before, after, before. So I didn't take this in count. But the bolts for the spacer are rubbing the dust cover from behind and I'm going to need to remove the disc to be able to remove the dust cover, so it sucks. So this is where the bolts are rubbing on the dust cover from behind, so that's why I'm going to remove it. I'm not needing this. I'm working on the other side. The rust helped me and it's removed by itself. Only this piece left. Okay, the dust cover is removed. And no more rubbing. Let's go back to the days of the underground. This is how it looks with the spacers. This is how wide the front was get. And now I'm going to rotate the wheel and for sure I'm going to rub in the plastic fenders. And probably I'm going to need to lift up the coilovers 2 cm.